I kill everything that's been trying to kill your happiness. There is a demon on assignment that's been meddling every time you try to have a relationship. That demon, oh my God, it meddles. Am I telling the truth? And you've been going through a hidden depression, but tonight the power of God is going to set you free. Now I'm telling you, when you leave out of here, you're going to have attitude, baby, because you're leaving a different way, and you are beautiful. God told me to tell you that you are beautiful, and your finances are about to shift. I'm telling you, start counting down 5 days and everything is going to shift. Now there is an anointing, you demon of depression. I command you and I cure you by the power of the blood of Jesus to loose up now. I can't hear nobody praying here. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Come here, Becky. Reba, lay your hand on the stomach. Rita, lay your hand there now. Come on, feel with it. Aya, it's a Rita Shaka. Yeah, it's a good deal now. Yes, there it is. It's a good deal. Somebody give God glory. Come here, mother. Yes, darling, what did you need? Okay. Sweetie, somebody call her. You won't be the same again. Did you feel when that burden lifted off you? Come on, just lift your hand and tell God thank you. What's wrong? His nose been bleeding for 2 days. Stay right there, mother. Come in, son. Is he in pain or is he just crying because his nose bleeding? I need to know. Look at me, baby bear. I can stop it that it won't bleed again, but you've got to pull yourself together. And I know you're a little afraid, but it's going to be okay, all right? All right, let's check it out and see if it's still bleeding. Check it out. Let us check it out. Go ahead and wipe his nose, and I'm going to come right back to him. Get him all cleaned up. Then we're going to curse that booger, and that thing ain't going to come back. Amen? But we've got to let him calm down, because he ain't in no pain. He's just scared. Lord, we can't work in the middle of that fear. He's going to be all right. Just sit him down. Sit him down, booger. Amen. And get the pull up the tip of his nose like you do, and then we'll curse. Okay? Mother, you said you had a knee replacement in which knee? It's the right one. You know why? Because I can feel it in this knee, and if I turn this way, it's over there. Okay? Uh-huh. So you had and so when they did the knee replacement, they pinched the nerve that went all the way in your spine. Where at? Let me see if I can find it. Let me see. Do it again, because I don't want to miss it. Excuse me. And I ain't no witch. Because I got more power than a witch. Stop looking at me like that. Let me tell you something. Witches need bones. I don't need
a
broom.
That's right.
In the spirit. How would you tell a witch or a warlock between a real woman or man of God? Now, the Bible says in the book of Matthew 7:21-22, men were saying that day, Lord, I prophesied. Prophecy is a gift. Gifts and callings are without repentance. Witches can prophesy to a living. Lord, I cast out devils. There are 3 ways to expel a devil. Through direct command, come out! Yes. And the devil got to obey. But witches can do that.
So
you can expel a devil through counseling, giving people knowledge. And the Bible says, once you fill them with knowledge, if they resist the devil, he'll flee. The 3rd way to expel a devil is through the preaching of the word of God. You can preach faith into a person. that they will believe, but they are stuck and they are receiving. Okay? And then they're going to say, we had wonderful works. That word works in the Greek is interpreted miracle. Now, there's the gift of working of miracles is a gift. Just in going without repentance. Working of miracles are not different kinds of miracles. Working of miracles, that gift is different categories of miracles. You got miracles of nature. You got miracles of healing, which is a direct deliverance on the spot. You got specialty area of miracles, and you got special miracles. Now, when they go to him and say, we did wonderful work, miracles in your name, what kind of miracles would that be from a witch, someone with a witch or warlock spirit? It would be a miracle of nature. Because the Bible said in Revelation, the 13th chapter, that the prophet of the Antichrist spoke into the atmosphere by King Death. Why? Because the devil is what? The prince of the air. His kingdom, the second heaven, is above us, and he deals in atmosphere stuff. I just thought I would give you that clue. So, the Bible says in the book of Mark, the 3rd chapter, Satan cannot cast out Satan. Kingdom divided against itself will not stand. The Beelzebub has nothing to do with miracles of healing. Witches cannot heal the sick, and witches cannot pour disease out of people's body, because they will be working against themselves. And witches, somebody say witches. Go ahead. Go ahead. They cannot stop like that. So I'm not a witch. So stop saying that witch got power. Witches can't do this. It's just something else they do. They charge you for healing. Every time you go to the root doctor, even for consultation, you got to have some money. But the Bible says, excuse me, when Naaman was sick unto, come on, he had the leprosy. And the man of God, the prophet, gives him the instruction, tells him what to do to be healed. He says, the Naaman, let me give you a gift, let me give you money and stuff. He said, if it was for information prophetically, looking in the matrix, I'd do it. But because it's for healing, I can't take no money for healing. Let me find. Stretch your hands. Lord, just give me a few more minutes. I ain't gonna be able to pray for everybody now. Time won't permit. Maybe there we'll get back together with my friends for a revival or something. This is a specialty area. Special need. Not quite, that is there, but not quite. Right over in here? Is it right here? That's exactly where it is. You got pain there, madam? You feel the pain, right? Okay, I'm gonna move it, okay? I'm gonna just move it a little bit. I'm gonna move the pain from one spot to the other. Why don't you stand in front of her? Thank you. Thank you, madam. Thank you, prophet. But that's what you want. Okay, that's what God has called you. Awesome prophet. Namaste. Somebody stand right there behind. I don't know. She may fall. Just go back a little tidbit. Right there, madam. She may fall and she may not fall. Okay, let me move it over a little bit just to show you it's real. I almost got it. Not quite. Shh, shh. Not quite. Let me get my facts here. Not right there, no pain, is it? It's here. You feel it here? Look at where did I take it? Did I take it here? It's right here. So I moved it from there to there. Now let me move it all the way. Okay, hold on. Almost got it. Once I grab it, I can take it out. Okay. Feeling the pain? All the pain gone? You sure? Bend down. Mother, feeling the pain? No pain at all, mother? No pain. Now I want to do something there. How? I want to take care of that knee. How's that knee feeling? It's real tight. You don't usually pick it up and kick it. You don't. You pick it up, but it's tight. You don't dance on that knee. My musician's ready. I told you he's going to drop it like it's hot in a minute, boy.